Welcome back. I've actually done a bit here since you guys were last with us. I added some, well, these, I guess you'd call them row houses. I thought they looked kind of neat. I also did finally put in the path here. I figured, so we've got a very kind of a dirty path, right? Kind of a, it's like a well-worn, you know, this would have been one of the first roads, but they take care of it over here. I don't know. We're going to have to figure out just what we want to do. And maybe this is just all these different types of paths here. Maybe, you know, this is just seeing which one we like best. At the end of the day, it's Racer's Castle, so he'll have final say. But for over here, I thought putting gravel down between these two, what are these? Stone slabs. So gravel down, stone slabs. It is just flat in here with the ground, which, eh. So that's kind of dull, but I don't know. I think it works out okay. Come over here. Path goes up. Couple of row houses. They're tall. You know, it's like a duplex almost. I like this. I think this is kind of neat. Lighting, you know, torches. Is torches or glowstone? Torches or glowstone? Maybe I can figure out some redstone lamps. I do have a lot of redstone. I'm not very good with redstone, but I figure a lamp shouldn't be too terribly difficult, right? But for right now, it's glowstone, and that's just a fence gate. But it looks like it's supporting it, so I dig it. Go inside, very thin down here. I put a closet under the stairs. You guys know I like doing that. But I figure, you know, a small kitchen down here, come upstairs, and there's room for, you know, a bed, maybe a desk, and geez, I started this video and it's already turning night. The other side looks exactly the same. Flip it and reverse it. Boom. Oh, I still have to put in some of these guys for railings. I went with yellow stained clay. I thought that was, you know, it felt kind of bold. I know, big deal. But yellow, it's a bold color. But you know what? I think this color palette works. I think it looks friggin' adorable. Spruce doors up there, kind of like shutters. Pretty simple roof on top of that, but I like the way the building is fatter at the top. I think that's neat, as evidenced by all these frickin' buildings. We hit on a theme, and I'm having a time breaking away from it. Go to sleep. Sleep, sleep, sleep. Okay, yeah, super exciting. Anyway, it's been a while. I've been busy. I've been trying to go to bed at a decent hour these days. I'm working out a lot, and I have been working out, but lately the gains are not what I've been wanting them to be. Hello. That's right. The gains aren't there, and the numbers aren't getting higher, and I'm a gamer. I like seeing those numbers get bigger, you know? And I think a big part of that was I wasn't getting sleep. You know, I get up, I go to work in the morning. I'm out the door at 6:50. I'm done with work around, you know, done with work at 5. Then I hit the gym. I'm in the gym until 6:30. By the time I get home, it's 7. Make something to eat. Make sure I got food for the next day. And by then, I'm looking at 9 o'clock. And used to be, I'd hop on and play Minecraft till... God. Oops, sorry, I just hit the microphone there. Yeah, I'd hop on and play Minecraft until midnight or 1 in the morning, and that, you know, leaves 5 hours of sleep. Es no bueno. Body needs time to heal. Got on tonight because I managed to prep last Sunday for the whole week. So tonight when I got home, I just had half a dozen eggs for dinner, and that was, you know, quick and easy to cook, and took a shower and hopped on, and it was, you know, it's only 8:30 right now, so I got some time. Figured I'd shoot a quick video. I threw in this house over here. It's kind of a long house. To make it a little bit interesting, I just took the roof and pitched it out this way a little bit. Hit up that color palette a little. Threw some stone brick in there. Still gotta figure out what kind of glass I want in there. And I need to obviously work out an interior, but I brought this door specifically for this house. God, walking around holding doors. Gotta figure out how I'm gonna, like, close off this stairwell. I kinda dig that stairwell. I also am gonna have to take a trip to the Nether because I have officially run out of glowstone. So it's either go to the Nether or do a whole bunch of excavating. Them is my choices. I do have a silk touch pickaxe though, so the Nether doesn't sound too awful. Of course, I haven't been in forever, so who knows. We'll put a bedroom up here. Like, this is kind of a richer person's house, I think. We'll throw a bedroom up here. He'll have a large-ish, comparatively, kitchen slash dining room slash living area down here. I don't know, we'll do something about this. I kind of dig it. We'll work it out. In the meantime, wanted to work on another building. And we've got this cool terrain change here, so I'm trying to take advantage of that. And I started with just a box here, and then I threw another box on the back of it, or a rectangle rather. And it's got a level change here, as you can see. And then I thought, let's put a circular, like, tower on this corner. Because circles are hard, and I'm no good at them. But you gotta challenge yourself if you wanna grow, right? So I'm just trying to plot this out with dirt right now. And obviously what's gonna happen is... And I had to do it as a full circle. My mind just wasn't tracking properly. But now I've got the outline. It's going to go... This is as wide as I want this to get. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut right here. Right? And grab that. So the roof for this, I guess we'll call it the, I don't know if this is the front or the back of this house, building, whatever it ends up being. This will get a triangular pitched roof, and I'm thinking it'll run this way. So like, if we were to give it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I'm standing dead center. 1, 2, 3. This would have a ridge line right here going across this way. Right? Boom, boom. And boom. And that roof is gonna... We're gonna have to figure out a way. It's gonna run into that. It's gonna work somehow. I gotta figure this out. Because if we pitch the roof this way, that might not actually work. I want these roofs to go two different directions. So, you know, if this one runs this way, then this one's going to run that way. But maybe I'll swap that out. Maybe this one will run across here, and this one will run long ways. And I think maybe this would cut into it better that way. Yeah, I think that's going to work better. Sitting here doing this now, and I'm realizing I should have waited on that whole story about the working out until I was doing this nonsense instead of just running around looking at stuff. But I never claimed to be the smartest videographer in the world. I'm gonna get to work on some of this. We'll bring you back in a little bit. I want this little parapet tower circular outcropping here. I want to make it interesting. So I'm gonna try to figure that out, and I'll bring you guys back once I've made a little bit of progress. Alright. As always, back in a flash. So, yeah, what is that called? Tree feller. Love it. This guy never did grow over here. So, ooh. Start a mini dark oak farm right out here. Why not, right? See if those grow. Anyway. I've mentioned him 100 times before, but, you know, he's watching B-dubs again, B00100 on YouTube, find him, watch him. He's much better than me, so go watch him. Anyway, I was watching him and he was talking about the importance of story when you're building, because it could be very easy to fall into a routine, fall into a slump where every building you make ends up looking exactly the same. It's a box with a roof that's got the same pitch. These roofs, I am going to have to start experimenting with different things. I'm also going to have to cover that up with something. I don't know, I'll figure something out. Anyway, the building has to have a story, and it can be something as simple as, this guy is the foreman that runs the lumber mill, right? So he built himself a very nice, he's got the stone bricks, he can afford it. He built himself this very nice house, and right next to it are a couple of row houses that some of his employees can live in. Right? Pretty, you know, it makes the world make sense. He owns this, he owns this, he owns that. And he's a smart guy because he makes his employees rent the row houses from him. And of course it's turning nighttime. Because of course it is. I never pay attention. Whatever, we're gonna risk it. Hell, if a skeleton spawns, that'd be cool, because I could use some bone meal. Anyway, what's the story with this house? Well, let's think about this. I want to do, like, a parapet over here, right? So, for me, the story with this house is, this was one of the original expansions to the castle. And this was an old guard tower. I'm gonna build it up higher. It's an old guard tower, right? So it starts at the base here with this cobblestone, and then it's gonna build up, and it'll go up fairly high, and I'll put a roof on it. But the guard tower fell into disrepair and ended up getting all open down here at the bottom, right? The wall was falling down. The thing was was about to collapse, but one of the residents of the castle decided he wanted to build his house into the guard tower. So he just got himself some lumber from the lumber mill, and he started working. And so what we end up with is this guard tower is where he started, and he built this frame around it. And then when he got to the hill here, or maybe just later on, he decided his house was too small, he needed an addition. Maybe they had a kid or something. Who knows? So he built this addition onto his house. So he started with a guard tower, built a house onto the guard tower, and then built an addition onto his house. And see, so it's got a story. You know, it's got a purpose for why it looks the way it looks. And so that's kind of informing my choices here now. This was a guard tower, which means I have to build this up as though it were a guard tower. And by the by, circles are frickin' hard. They're difficult. Do I gotta fix something over here? No? No, everything looks the same. So, the story. That's what we're going for here. And I think it's gonna work out. Now, I am gonna run back to the inn. I need to start carrying a bed on me, I think. Okay. Yeah, we can do it. Yeah, you're bleeding. I know that makes sense, right? Because you're a skeleton. He just ran away, huh? Come on, buddy. Yeah, come on. I ain't afraid of you, creepy mother. Ha ha. Oh, I've got so many ender pearls now. And by so many, I mean like 10. But, if you saw the adventure video I posted, God, it's been probably a month ago now, you know we found an end portal, and it was missing those eyes of Ender. So I've got multiple reasons to go into the Nether now, because I need to get blaze rods. Because we need to make some eyes of Ender and get that end portal going. Because I tell you the truth, never been. So I think that could be super cool. Anyway, now that you've watched me go to sleep, I'm gonna cut this here, do a little bit more work on the house. The guard tower turned into a house, and I'll bring you guys back in once I've made a little bit more progress. I had to go get some dark oak because I decided I was going to use dark oak. Hello, skeleton. What are you doing in my lumber mill? Die. Haha. And I got my bones for bone meal. Alright. Back in a flash. Well, holy crap, guys. It actually kinda works. It's kinda neat. I love the way the roof is all crazy-like. I really, really dig it. So, let me show you. Boop. What's going on? Now, the inside isn't anything yet. The inside looks pretty ugly. Because it does. Hello, sheep. Right? You got beams all over the place. But you know what? That can also be kind of cool. So, here's thought process, right? stairway going up here. This'll get covered. You know, we'll make this floor flat on the inside here. This'll be floor level, right? Pretty tall room. Maybe even there'll be another level up in the peak. Probably. We'll see. Of course, it's getting nighttime again, because that's just how these things work. Maybe, no promises here, but maybe I'll get the hang of this by the end of this episode. We'll see. So, if we go back outside, you see how the roof just kind of builds right into that? It's cool, isn't it? Oh, it's so groovy. This is a building I'm actually pretty excited about. I think it's gonna look pretty cool. And the other thing here is it's not, like, you go inside and you can, you know, look, it's not super huge by any means. But I think that's actually gonna make the interior design easier. Because I have a habit of making these massive buildings because I want them to look really cool on the outside. And then I get on the inside and have no idea how to fill it in. But I think this is going to look kind of... this is going to look pretty neat. We might even... in fact, I know we are. We're going to bring out a couple blocks here. And there'll be windows. Oh, that's going to be cool. Alright, this was a short clip. Whoa, hello. Short clip as I run back to the inn. And honestly, you guys won't notice, but this is going to be a... well, hello. This is going to be... come here, you. Yeah. Ah! There we go. This is going to be a couple days for me, probably, but for you guys, it'll be one episode through the magic of video editing. Anyway, we will, as always, be back in a flash. Hey guys, so we're back, and... I don't know that I ever showed you guys this. Finally put something in there. I'm in the basement of my house, and I finally made the cactus farm. I know I mentioned it once before, but it's pretty simple, but it does give me all the cactus that I could possibly want. Starting to build up a collection here, which means green dye. So, green dye will not be an issue anymore. Oh, wait. Jesus. I brought you guys in, and the whole reason I'm even down here is to check my glass storage because I need some more of this. And I might need more than that. I'm not real sure. Anyway. Hello, house. Yeah, it's actually been... it's been a minute since I've been out this way. Like, I've been pretty much living in Racer's Castle for the past I don't know how long now. But it's been fun. I like working in there. We'll come back here. We'll add more. We'll make the town even more vibrant. It'll happen. I'm just getting sucked in over here, you know? So, anyway, a little bit, let's see, I had something that I was going to talk about, and then I hopped in and started recording, and just gone. Just gone. Ah, Jesus. Got my blue stained glass. I did a little bit of work today, at work, See, I'm incredibly lucky. I have a really great job. Probably not too terribly uncommon for people that post, you know, videos of video games online. I work in IT, and on my lunch break, I'm not doing this while I'm actually at work. God forbid one of my bosses sees this and is like, "What are you doing?" Actually, no, my bosses are freaking cool. But anyway, I did a lot of work on my lunch break at work, and I've got the tower kinda almost finished here. And I need this blue stained glass because I had some in another chest out here and I started working there. So I need to pillar up that way. And anyway. There? And there. Yeah. Alright. And down we go. It says doing work on my lunch break, and I got this pretty well sorted. It's definitely not finished, you know, by any means, but it is getting there. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Okay, silk touch. Got it. Ha ha! And two panes to spare. Two pane. Little window. I went in and I hit the walls with some spruce wood to kind of give it that old hodgepodge feel. You know, this guy's just using what he's got on hand, right? So there's some oak, there's some spruce. It's all thrown together. I know we were talking about this being an addition, right? But then I got to thinking, you know, the main road, well, one of the main roadways is coming up this way, right? And it just didn't make sense to me. I couldn't, I mean, I guess maybe I could kick in a door here. But let me take you inside, because that it feels weird to me. So we put a door in here, and we've got this really little entrance room, right? Oh, I did go into the Nether. I survived. I found some glowstone right by the portal, and bam, there it is. Little entranceway. Come in here, the ceiling gets all wonky. But that works. I mean, dude's working with what he's got. So you see, if I kicked in a door here, it would be right by this stairway, which is, you know, it's subject to change. Maybe I knock these out and it's just the one, because that might give me some more room down here. I might, yeah, you know what, just looking at it, that's what I want to do. So knock these out. Ah, not that, darn it. I'm getting pick happy down here. Alright. Boom, boom, boom. Hey! Glowstone dust. Leveling up the digging. Oh, that was perfect. Alright, so. Oh, that means I can take this ceiling over here. It might not look so wonky. I can switch glowstone. Alright, cool. Go up the stairs. We're up the stairs. Sunk some glowstone in there, too, for some lighting. So we're up the stairs, and we've got, he threw this floor in, the guy that was building into this house threw that floor in, because originally, you know, it would have been different in here as a guard tower. But he ripped it out, or it rotted out, you know, as it was deteriorating. So that's why these big windows here, they actually span the floor, and they come up here. And I figure I'll put a bedroom up here, and maybe if that's high enough, maybe I can drop a glowstone chandelier here. And this will be like a master bedroom, right? I feel like my voice is going really high right now. I don't know why that is. But yeah, And I kind of dig this weird, oddly shaped, you know, this weird shape. It adds character to this building, I think. So I'm pretty excited about that. I think that's kind of neat. And if we run over here, get some distance. I think that's okay. I tell you what, I made some cobblestone walls. And part of me really, really wants to throw those cobblestone walls in these corners here to kind of build it up a little bit. Because right now, I don't know, does that feel too jarring to you? That's the thing with Minecraft, you know, you got the blocks, and they are the size that they are, and there's not a lot you can do about that. So maybe I'll grab those cobblestone walls and hit that in the center there. I wanted to bring you guys in mostly just to show you the progress that I made during lunch. That's crazy. Oh, but here's the other thing, and we're gonna risk the night. I know I haven't learned a damn thing, but whatever. I'm gonna go out this way. Because, you know, on my lunch break, it's easy to pull up Minecraft and just run about and do random... I don't know what that is. Somebody's been out here. Just do random stuff. So one of those random things that I did, do you see that up there? Isn't that cool? This was like just a random Tuesday or something at work on my lunch break. I was like, I just feel like building something. And I feel like practicing. Oh my god, yep, here they come. I don't have time for you, I'm talking. I just felt like building something, you know? The urge hit, I had a creative kind of mood going on. And I don't know if I'm gonna cut a path up this hill or what I'm gonna do. But I was like, I need to practice circles. I need to practice circles, and I want to see if I can't do like a wasted, and by that's WAISTED, like a waste, like somebody's waste. A wasted tower, where it's fatter at the bottom, skinny in the middle, and fatter back at the top, right? So that is what I've got going on here. And yeah, it's not perfect. It's far from perfect. You know, the middle's completely square, the top is only vaguely circular. You know, it's really more of a... I don't even know what you would call that shape. The bottom started off pretty okay. I've got this signal fire going on up here. Get some wicked cool views. It's like a witch's tower, and you come out on the back here and like, isn't that just cool? Oh, and it's snowing, how neat. The Minecraft world generation has gotten really cool. You know, I was playing back in like 1.2, 1.3, but back then it was really just, you know, it was still, they still had like the free version available as a Flash game on their website. So it was just, it was Legos. It was Legos on the computer, and it was just a time waster. I didn't know what I was doing or what the game was about or anything like that. But, you know, I've been around for a while. I just, you know, I leave it, I come back, I leave it, I come back. So I am still very much a noob, but I have been around long enough to see the advances in the game. And the world generation is one of those things that's just been really, really cool. And I really dig it. It's rad. So yeah, cool little signal fire. Signal fire, not signifier. I brought some obsidian up here and I made another nether portal. Because I thought maybe this would be far enough away from the other one, but you know what, it's not. Anyway, come in here, and it's very simple. You know, it's nothing spectacular by any means. I put in a spiral staircase. some green stained glass because God knows I've got enough cactus, right? Come up here, and it's just a room. You know, I got a bed and some chests and a crafting table. Oh, that looks pretty cool though. So yeah, I built this thing out here. Go to sleep, get some daylight. But I wanted to bring you guys in just to show you what's been done. I'm gonna get back to work on that house, cause it's not quite finished yet. And we'll bring you back in when it's finished. I think though, you know, I keep talking about going into the Nether and getting stuff. And, yeah, I'm carrying ender pearls. You know, I went back to my house and I forgot to put that away. Because I am absent-minded. Look at that pig. Pig on top of a... guess he must have just spawned up there. Or pigs learn to fly. It's a cool world. It's a cool world. So yeah, let's hit the Nether. Why not? Why not? I am all over the place today. Oh, okay, there we go. Hello. Not touching you. I'm not touching you. So, whoa! Who's shooting? Okay. Hi. Where are you? Okay. Oh my god. Do I have my bow? Yes, I have my bow. Alright, dude. Are you still there? Huh? Peekaboo. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Oh god, I'm on fire. I'm not on fire. Okay. See, I hate the Nether. I hate this place. I hate it. It looks like hell. It is hell. Oh, hey, look. There's where I got the glowstone. We did find... We found another fortress. And it was terrifying. And I didn't record it. But it was terrifying. Lots of screaming. Lots of people dying. It was wonderful. Oh, what am I doing in here? You know what? I'm going to use that portal. Because I'll show you what happens. Yeah, real short trip to the Nether. Ah, jeez. Knocked out that wall, too. You jerk. Alright. Bye, you weirdo. Ha ha! So, I thought it would be far enough away that it wouldn't do that. But you know what? Now that I've done that a couple of times, I think I might be okay with it, because that's one way that I don't know if running from Racer's Castle to that tower on the hill is faster than just running all the way back home, but it's kind of like a shortcut. Kinda, right? Anyway, I'm gonna head downstairs, I'm gonna put that stuff away, I'm gonna collect my thoughts, do some work, and then bring you guys back in when I have a frickin' plan, right? Oh yeah, look at that. Yes. Things are looking up. Yes. Okay, yeah. Like I said, a couple of times now. God, this is gonna be terrible to edit. I will bring you guys back, as always, in a flash. Hey guys, good morning. Or, well, just welcome back. Or, actually, you know, it's been like all of a second and a half for you, so, hi! How's it going? I just ran home. I've actually pretty much finished that building now. I just ran home. Man, there are... went to sleep, and there are monsters all over the village, naturally, but we're not going to waste time on them. They can just burn up and die in the sun. I ran all the way home to grab some glass. I got some light blue and one one regular blue glass plane. Plane? Pane. Because that's all I need to actually finish off that house I was building. I have not yet put in an interior, or rather nothing to really speak of. I fixed the ceiling, finished. You know what? Do you guys know what's going on over here? Just all of the villagers that you can't see right now. What the hell? Where are you guys? They're in there, though. They keep multiplying. And in this texture pack, or resource pack, rather, they're friggin' Jawas, so... I find it hilarious, but also, it's getting to be a little annoying. Anyway. Grab some glass from the house so I can run back here. I'm gonna finish the one we've been working on, and I brought some light blue for this one. So, as you can see, took the door out of there. So now there's just a window. I went through and I threw down bushes around the outside because you know I like doing that and it looks cool. And then we're going to hit all the ground around it with some bone meal because it's a simple, easy thing to do that just makes everything look better. Makes everything look like it fits into the world better. Oh, I should go ahead and show you guys this, huh? Who knows? Maybe I want to put something in this little spot here, too. Who knows? It could be like a little garden. But as you can see, I did throw the cobblestone walls, and I like it fills it out. To me, it makes it look more round. It's slightly less jarring of a transition. I went ahead and I put in the door down here, and I was just thinking, you know, how could I make this look cool? So I just did some path blocks and lined it in these oak leaves because I've got, and I'm gonna cut this all down because there will be more buildings on this side, but I've got all of these oak trees, so I got oak leaves and oak wood for days now. So it's a hedgerow. Dude put in a hedgerow. That's cool, right? So now this is the main entrance. We took the stairway out of this spot, and instead, now it just comes up this way. And I had a couple of extra walls, so I put those there as kind of a light type thing. Maybe, you know what, now that I'm looking at it? No. Stop. If I keep doing that, I'm gonna be here forever. Excuse me, I don't know why I'm sniffling like this. It's getting to be springtime. I think maybe the allergies are starting to work up. Who knows? Glowstone sunk into the ceiling there. The ceiling has a pattern that makes more sense, which I like. Come up here, and now this is just a room. This is just a room. And I'm going to throw a bed and a chest and maybe a little shelving here, and it's perfect. It's a little kid's room. I love it. Love it. This, you know, I'll have a stove and a sink and a little table maybe and a chest, little kitchen right here, boom, done. Come up here, maybe I'll throw a couple benches and some bookshelves, little library sitting area, and then you go all the way up. I did put the glowstone up here, and you've got, this will be a master bedroom. We'll put a double bed up here and make it look cool, but I'm not gonna, you know, force you guys through that, because honestly that takes me forever to figure out. I know it sounds like I've got it all planned, but the second I put something down, I'm gonna go, nope, don't like it, and tear it all up, and it'll take me forever. So I got this light blue because this guy's got one. Yeah! Yeah! Alright. Yeah, I went crazy with the oak leaf bushes. But you know what? I love it, and it makes these buildings look so much better, and it's so easy to do. Look, and now this alleyway. Ugh. Dude. So cool. And, you know, maybe I'll put a bin or two right here. Right? Like a trash bin or something. Could be cool. Could be cool. This still doesn't have any kind of an interior, but obviously come back through and I've got all that glowstone. Gonna have to cover this up here, I think. If we're gonna make this into a bedroom up here. But too cool, right? Too cool. That is our house built out of and into a guard tower. That's it. It had a story. Story is now complete. And it's a really neat little building with some level changes. And, you know, it wasn't the world's most difficult build. But I feel like it makes sense. And it looks neat. And it has a story. More to come, guys. More to come, for sure. And I think maybe we might get started on the castle next. Because I'm getting itchy. You know, I feel like if we get the castle built, then the rest of these little buildings, the stories of these little buildings out here, they'll be easier. It'll make more sense. It'll be good stuff. Something has to go here. And we've got to do something about how incredibly, obviously, square this is. I planted these trees to cut down, but they kind of work. And for now, because we don't know what's going on up here, the trees are staying up here. But stuff's going up there. Because that's a whole lot of real estate that we have not used yet. I think this place is starting to look pretty cool, though. Pretty excited about all the stuff in here. And I just hit my limit on the ums. So that's my cue. I gotta let you guys go. But leave a comment. Leave a like. Let me know what you think. I'm excited. I think this is pretty cool. So, as always, everybody have a wonderful evening, morning, afternoon, whatever the case may be. Be excellent, stay excellent, and we'll catch you on the next episode. Bye.